I wanted to share this testimony about erection problems among young men. It is a problem that is not well known in the medical field. General practitioners, you need to be better trained today for erection problems and provide good, comprehensive information and support. When I went to see my very first doctor, this problem was not taken seriously. But listen to me. Many young men might commit suicide because they never had an erection. We need to talk about it. GPs, you are the first contact when something is wrong. Today, the venous ligation surgery works very well. I am living proof. I am 31 years old. I started experiencing impotence 8 years ago. I was just 23. I noticed a slight decrease in the rigidity of my penis, which didn't worry me too much. I had also noticed that I was having fewer and fewer nocturnal erections and morning erections. I started to worry because when we had sexual intercourse, it didn't work at all anymore. I could no longer have sexual intercourse with penetration. It lasted for months and months. There was no improvement. I didn't know if it was a mechanical or perhaps a psychological issue. I'd rather thought that it might be psychological because at 23, having erectile dysfunction seemed impossible to me. I mustered up my courage and went to see my doctor. I explained to him that for almost a year, I hadn't been able to achieve my goals with my partner during sexual intercourse. He told me it was temporary. At my age, it's impossible to have mechanical problems. I went to see another, more specialized doctor. He didn't take my problem seriously, at least that's what I think. He told me it's all in my head. So, just to let you know, the first general practitioners I saw didn't take my problem seriously at all. They just asked me a few questions and immediately sent me off with a prescription for erection problem medication. It didn't go any further than that. Through my extensive research, I found a highly qualified and experienced doctor who specialized specifically in the field of the male genital organ. I explained all the steps I had gone through before. He took my problem seriously. He said, "Sir, I suspect a slightly venous leak, perhaps." When I heard that, I was very happy because we might have finally found my problem, which was mechanical. He then sent me to a specialized center. I had an echo Doppler. Then I was sent to have a cavernous scan. The result finally came in. So basically, the blood wouldn't stay in the penis, which made it impossible for me to have an erection. I was very happy to learn this because I thought maybe we will finally find a solution. I was referred to Professor Eric Hatter. I could say today that this man almost saved my life. He was one of the only surgeons in the world to perform surgery for venous leaks. It's basically an operation. To put it in my own word, they block the veins so the blood doesn't dissipate here and there. Today, thanks to this operation, I've regained my sexuality. Today, a solution for venous leaks is available. Admittedly, it remains a very taboo subject in society. Thank you for listening to me. I hope it helps you.